So we are solving some more questions of CAT 19 slot 1, part 4 of the series. We'll take up 5 questions and we'll look at how to go about solving them. A person invested total amount of 15 lakhs. A part of it was invested at fixed deposit at 6% and the remaining in the two others in a ratio of 2:1, earning 4% and 3%. Now to use allegation, I want two values. Here it is a mixture of three values, 1, 2 and 3. So what I'll do is I'll combine this 2:1 and 4 and 3. So by the weighted average approach, if you understand it directly, you can make out that the answer, the average of 4 and 3 in a ratio of 2:1 is 3.66. Or you can use a weighted average of 4 into 2 plus 3 into 1 upon 2 plus 1, 11 upon 3, which will give you 3.66%. Now 3.66 is the value of the second one. So fixed deposit is 6%. The second value is 3.66%. And you get a return of 76,000. 76,000, if you want, you can convert to percentage. Or you can convert it this percentage to value, whichever way you're comfortable. Okay, that is upon your comfort level, where you want to convert. Suppose I want to convert the 6% to value. 6%, 15 lakh will be 90,000. Okay, 15 lakh into 6% is 90,000. 3.66% is 11 upon 3. 11 upon 3% of 15 lakh will be 55,000. So these two I'm mixing to get 76,000 as the average. To do allegation, so this becomes 14,000. This becomes 21,000. So basically, I have to mix in the ratio of 3:2. So 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 stands for 15 lakhs into 3 times. So 3 will stand for into 3 times, which will be 9 lakhs as the answer. So answer will be 9. I repeat, I wanted to do allegation, so I combine 4 and 3 first. So 4 and 3 are mixed in a ratio of 2:1. So I found the average. So 4 into 2 plus 3 into 1 upon 2 plus 1, which will give you 3.66 as the average. Now this 3.66%, if I invest this complete 15 lakhs in 3.66%, I'll get 55,000. If I invest this complete 15 lakhs at 6%, I'll get 90,000. So I'm mixing these two ratios to get the average of 76,000. You can do allegation and get the ratio 3:2 and get the answer of 9 lakhs. The allegation is a good method to solve some things faster. So if you can understand that, it'll help you. You can do by normal equations also, but I'm a little against equation because it takes a little extra time to solve. By solving by faster methods, you normally save a lot of time and that helps you to solve more questions. A club has 256 members, of whom 144 can play football. Now this is basically a Venn diagram. If you want, you can draw a Venn diagram. Right? You have football 144, tennis 123, cricket 132, 58 members play football and tennis, 25 play cricket and tennis, and 60 play football and cricket. 63. If every member can play at least one game, that means the total 256 in this whole Venn diagram. And the number of members who can play only tennis is. The only value which you don't know is all the three here x. So here if you want, you can put equation and do it. 256 total is equal to 144 plus 132 plus 123. That is A union A plus B plus C minus A intersection B minus B intersection C minus A intersection C plus the all three common. This is a normal equation which is there for Venn diagram. Now solve this. 256 is equal to 399 minus 60 plus 50 is 110, 110 plus 20 is 130 plus 14, 144. So here is 58 is a mistake. 58 plus 25 plus 63. If you solve this, we'll get x equal to 3. Once you get x equal to 3, you want only tennis. So you can do that. 58 minus 3 is 55 out here. 25 minus 3 is 22 out here. Only tennis is 123 minus these three values, which comes to 80. So this will come to 43. D option is the answer. Normal Venn diagram, put the formula, you should immediately get the answer. So this is nothing out of textbook, basically out of textbook sum, which you should easily put the values and get the answer. Okay, a1 plus a2 plus a3. So here we have again n. We can put n as 1 first and try. So if I put n equal to 1, I will get a1 is equal to 3 into 2 square minus 2, which is 6. If I put n equal to 2, so a1 plus a2 will be 3 into 2 cube minus 2. This becomes 3, 2 cube is 8, 8 minus 2 is 6, 18. Similarly, if I do a1 plus a2 plus a3, just giving an example, you will get 3 into 2 raised to 4 minus 2, 2 raised to 4 is 16 minus 2, 14, 14 threes are 42. So from this you can make out a1 is 6, a2 becomes the difference of this, which is 12, a3 becomes difference of this, which is 24. You can make out it doubles every time. This keeps on doubling into 2, into 2. So a11 will be 6 into 2 raised to 10, 6 into 1024, 6144. Answer is 6144. You need to find pattern, that's all. That's the normally simple sums. Just put n equal to 1, you get a1 6. Put n equal to 2, you will see you'll get a2 12. Put n equal to 3, you will get a3 is 24. You can make out it doubles every time. So when you go to a11, it will be 6 first value into 2, multiply 10 times. Solve it, you should get 6144. The number of real roots of the equation. Normally what I do is I tend to draw the equations. If I draw the equation, this first part, cos. Cos of 0 is 1. So twice of 1 is 2. And the cos curve goes like this, somewhere like that. So it is x, x plus 1, but the cos curve goes something like that. And so on. Well, right hand side, when I put x equal to 0, I get 2. So I know they meet at this point. So that is one solution for sure. So 0 is ruled out. Now if I put values of x further, I see that it both increases on both sides. It doesn't decrease, it increases on both sides. If I put x as a higher number or x as a smaller number. Okay, for example, if I put x as 2, 3, 4, this will go to 4, 8, 16, something on that. If I put x as, let's say, half. If I put x as half, it becomes 2 raised to half plus 2 raised to minus half. Which is 2 raised to half plus 1 upon 2 raised to half. Then approximately 1.44 plus 1 upon 1.44. Then 0.66. It comes to 2 approximately. Right? Same if I put 2 raised to 0. 2 raised to 0 I know gives you 2. That is for sure. 2 raised to 1 gives you more than 2. 2.5. So I can make out a value increases on either side. So the minimum value will be at 2. So both of them intersect at x equal to 0. So there's only one solution on it. So I normally prefer drawing a graph. I look at a left hand side graph. Cos, the maximum value will come 2. And then decrease, increase, decrease, increases. The right hand side, I see the minimum value comes at 2 when x is 0. On both other sides, it will keep increasing if you look at it. So put values and check out. You see both sides, it keeps increasing. So automatically, you'll have only one solution which is there. Therefore, answer will be B, option 1. At the usual efficiency levels, A and B together can finish the task in 12 days. Basically, we want how many days would A take to finish the task? It has to be more than 12, because together if they finish in 12, it has to be that A alone should take more than 12. So D, option ruled out. ABC. So A had worked half his efficiency as he usually does, and B had worked thrice his efficiency as usually does. The task would have been completed in 8 days. So let me take a middle option. Okay, I'm just trying to substitute middle option. Suppose A takes 24 days, just, and A and B together takes 12 days, which means automatically B should also take 24 days, because only both of them take 24 days, together they will take half the number of days, 12 days. If I go back to second condition, A has worked half his efficiency, means A will now take 48 days, double the time. B worked thrice his efficiency, then we will take one third the time, which is 8 days. Because double the efficiency, time taken is half. Efficiency and time are inversely proportional. more the efficiency, less the time. Now, if B alone take 8 days, they can't complete a work in 9 days. So this is not possible. So if this is not possible, automatically it basically means that A should take less days to complete a work, because if it A takes more days, B will take less days, and this will become even lesser than that. Not possible. The only option is C option. I repeat, I first eliminated 12 by the data given to you. Then I substitute 24 and I checked it's not possible. Together it comes less than 9 days. So in order to get it to 9 days, I need to reduce the number of days of A and increase the number of days of B, because we are increasing the B's efficiency by 3 times. So automatically I can make out that A will take less than 24 days, which is 18 days. If you want, you can check out. So if A takes 18 days, together they take 12 days. You can do by any method. One is LCM method. 18, 12, if 36 units is the average. So A will do 2 units of work per day. Together they will do 3 units of work per day, which means B will do 1 unit of work per day. So B will take 36 days. So A takes 18, B takes 36. Now, if A works in half the efficiency, so A will take 36 days. B works at thrice the efficiency, B will take 1/3 days, which is 12 days. Now, if I do 36 and 12 together, so LCM is 36. A will do 1 unit of work, B will do 3 units of work. Together, they do 4 units of work per day. So, to complete 36 units of work per day, they will take 9 days. Satisfies. So from there, I just checked. This is not required. I've just checked it, but not required. A normal equation method is where you can use A and B as the amount of work done per day. So A is the amount of work done by A in 1 day, and B is the amount of work done by B in 1 day. So we know 12 A plus 12 B is equal to the complete work, 100% work 1 day. Instead of that, A has worked at half the efficiency. Okay, that means A has worked at half the efficiency and B has worked at thrice the efficiency. And they work for 9 days each. Again, they complete the work. So which means 4.5 A plus 27 B also completes the work in 1 day. Now, since this right hand side is both 1 and 1, you can compare the left hand side. So difference in A is 7.5. So 7.5 A does same work as difference in B, which is 15 B. 7.5 A is same as 15 B, because as much work A does more out here, that much work B does less out here, and same thing. So which we can make out that A upon B will be 2 upon 1. So A does double the work as B. If A does double the work as B, he will take half as number of days. So then you can take, if B takes X days to complete the work, if B takes, A takes X days to complete the work, B will take 2X days to complete the work. And 1 upon X plus 1 upon 2X will be equal to 1 upon 12. With this also, if you solve, you should get X as 18. C option. I repeat, we assume A is the amount of work done by A by 1 day. B is the amount of work done by B in 1 day. Together, 12A plus 12B equal to 1. Because 12 days they work, they complete the work in 1 day. Now, A does half the work, B does thrice the work. So, 9 into A by 2 plus 9 into 3B will be equal to 1. So, you can solve simultaneously also. You will get 7.5A equal to 15B. Subtract it if you want. Subtract, you get 7.5A equal to 15B. From that, we'll get A upon B as 2:1. So, A is double as efficient as B, which means B will take twice as much time as A. Substitute and you'll get X equal to 18. Either way you can solve. Hope it's clear. Thank you.